हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू बेस्ट फ्रेंड स्टडी। ईद मुबारक फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल। हैप्पी रमजान टू ऑल द व्यूअर्स ओवर देयर। सो ईद मुबारक। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द मोस्ट इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक वेयर मेनी ऑफ द व्यूअर्स आस्क मी टू मेक दिस वीडियो सिंस लॉन्ग। सो फाइनली आई एम मेकिंग दिस वीडियो, आई एम ग्लैड फॉर दैट। सो हाउ टू पास इन सप्लीमेंट्री एंड हाउ टू क्लियर द सब्जेक्ट्स इन सप्लीमेंट्री as well as how to improve your marks in betterment. Okay, so this is the content of the video which we are going to discuss today. So let's begin our video. So coming to supplementary, it is the general video where it is to the person who have one subject in supplementary or all the subjects in supplementary. So it is generally for all the students. So coming to supplementary, first you have to make a schedule of your timetable, like when is your exam and your timetable according to it. For example, if my exam is within 4 to 5 days, so worst case, okay, if it is more than 4 to 5 days or if it is more than 1 month, that's the great thing. So if there is 1 week for my supplementary exam, for example, so then what you need to do is you have to make timetable. Okay, if you have the subjects in supplementary, first of all make the timetable for them. And the toughest subject which you feel to pass, give it more priority. Okay, just concentrate more on that subject and give more time for that subject preparation. Okay, and other most important thing is that after scheduling, you have to refer to previous year's papers. Okay, last 4 to 5 years papers, like supplementary as well as main papers will be. So if you just refer to them, what happens is you can easily pass in your supplementary, trust me. Because you know, coming to supplementary, most of the questions will be repeating from 4 to 5 years of previous mains papers as well as supplies papers or compartment papers. So, as supplementary exam is also called as compartment exam. So, and you know, other thing is preparing is one stage, and you know, presenting in the exam is another stage. Okay, so though you know the answer correctly, you have to present it nicely, like in a good way. For example, let's take two students. Okay, so one student. Like two students have the same knowledge. Student A presented the answer neatly, okay, with the points, with underlining, with using blue and black pens, and you know, with drawing lines at the edges of the paper and drawing diagrams and all. And person B, student B, knows the same answer, have the same knowledge as person A, but he wrote the same answer in the point, like you know, instead of points, he wrote the answer or she wrote the answer in a form of paragraph without underlining, without neat handwriting, no presentation skills. Then obviously, if the answer is 10 marks, student A is going to get 8.5 or 9, whereas student B will get only 4 or 5 marks at max. Okay, because coming to supplementary exams or coming to main exams, no faculty or no invisible, like you know, no examiner, the person who is going to correct your exam papers, he will not spend more than 1 minute on your paper. At max, he's going to spend 1.5 minute on your paper correction. So first of all, if I'm the examiner, like suppose if I'm the examiner, I'll just take out the paper, look at the handwriting first and look at the presentation skills first. And the person who corrects your paper reads only first two answers. Okay, based upon the first two answers, he is going to evaluate your marks rest of the paper. Okay, so make sure you have to present well. Okay, so mainly, I have given you two tips. First thing is timetable, prepare a schedule and follow it. Second thing is presentation skills, and you have to present really well. Handwriting should be really attractive. If you, for example, if it is like physics or chemistry or you know, maths, it will have a few formulae, right? Important formulae. while solving the problem, just make it a box around the formulae. So if this is the formulae, just draw a box around the formulae so that with a pencil, so that it will be highlighted and you'll be getting more marks, okay? You'll be almost getting full marks for that answer, okay? So presentation skills, most of the students, though they have knowledge, they'll lose marks or they'll fail just with the lack of presentation skills, okay? And for example, if the subject is a biology, you'll have diagrams, you'll have some important terms, okay? Just highlight them with a blue pen or black pen. And coming to diagram, just neatly draw the diagram with a pencil and just write the parts of the diagram with the help of black pen or blue pen, okay? So presentation skills are like very important for board exams, because as I said, you, the person who is going to correct your paper, is not going to spend more than 1.5 minutes on your paper, okay? So first two answers, yes. Third important tip is that, for example, I'm just taking example, they gave you 10 questions. Out of 10 questions, they asked you to attempt any 8 questions. Worst case, 8 questions, okay? I'm just generally taking an example. Out of 10 questions, you are asked to attempt 8 questions, okay? So out of those 8 questions, you know only 5 questions. And remaining 3 questions, you are not sure about it. You just wanted to try, okay? So that you not lose marks. So what happens is, in the 5 answers which you know very well also, select 2 answers which you are perfect. Like you're going to get 2 out of 2 marks or 5 out of 5 marks. Those kind of answers like in which you are very confident. Select those out of 5. Select any 2 answers which you are damn sure that you are going to present them well and which you are damn sure that you are going to write them well and confident about securing full out of full marks, okay? So concentrate on two answers first and write in a way. If it is for long answer, first write definition, okay? For example, explain photosynthesis. What is photosynthesis? So these kind of answers they have asked you. First write what is photosynthesis, okay? The process of photosynthesis. First write photosynthesis, underline it. From the next line, start defining the photosynthesis within 2 or 3 lines based upon your marks, okay? For example, if the answer is 7 marks, you have to write the photosynthesis definition, write the points after definition, write the photon, explain the photosynthesis procedure in the form of points, okay? Another advantage of writing the question, writing the answers in the points is that if you write the answer in paragraph, you will get only 5 lines, for example. The same answer, if you write in points, you'll get 8 to 10 lines. So it will even look in long, like, you know, it will even fill the page. That is another advantage. So, as I said, first you're going to write a definition, then you're going to explain it. Then draw a diagram related to the answer, okay? And if you have, coming to Max, if you have any important formulae, underline them, make them in a box, in a form of box, and hence proved, like such kind of statements in maths are very important. And for example, coming to maths, they have asked you to prove, they have given you a statement and asked you prove A is equal to B. Last, what you need to do is, after doing all the problem, like the complete problem, at last you have to write, therefore A is equal to B, hence proved, okay? So these two statements, if you highlight, you're going to get full marks. That too in marks, in mathematics, in maths, you are like, you know, you should not give the examiner to even cut a single mark, because it is a subject where you can score 100 out of 100. So, okay, so I told you how to present. I said you out of 5, out of 10, you know, 8 answers, out of them, you know 5 perfectly, and in that 5, 2 you have to present first questions which you are perfect about them, okay, you wrote them. After that, the questions which you know, present them. After perfect answers, write the answers which you know like I can attempt it. So such kind of answers, just write them. So after them, few answers, 1 to 2 answers, for example, you don't know them, but you have idea of the concept. Okay, just write in own, because answers will, you'll not have negative marking in supplementary. So you are free to, you can happily write the answers which you know, which is related to the concept. Okay, so I'll tell you an example. Few students will not know the answers. They'll write the guess mark answers in the first of the paper. Okay, so starting, if I'm the examiner, I'll see the answer, it is absolutely wrong. So the first answer itself wrong. So how can I expect you to give the good answers in the later papers? Okay, so I'm going to have the impression that you are not a good student, you didn't do anything in this exam, you are absolutely just guessing the answers and concepts, so I'm going to fail you. Like, you know, invigilators, like examiners will be like that, not me, examiners will be like that. So you know, first page of your exam paper answer sheet is damn important. Okay, it can give you 100 out of 100, or it can fail you. Only the first paper can decide your marks, trust me. Okay, so these are the three tips, and the fourth tip is the subjects which you are not understanding, the subjects which you're not feeling to study. Do one thing, you know, I said you just first of all collect last 4 to 5 years supplementary papers as well as main exam papers. From those papers, just analyze the papers. Okay, which topics or which concepts or which type of questions are giving, like, you know, are appearing in exam each and every year. Okay, so those kind of questions note down and practice them again and again. Trust me, you'll easily pass. Okay, and coming to next thing, time management in exam is very important. Okay, few students I've seen during my education, like when I was studying, I saw few students. They are intelligent, they are brilliant, they have knowledge, but the thing is, out of 3 hours, for example, let's consider exam time is 3 hours. Out of 3 hours, 1 hour they will be wasting time by, you know, by staring at others, by seeing what others are doing, by seeing what others are writing, by, you know, doing just time pass. Okay, last 2 hours will be left. Then they'll start reading question paper. Okay, even though they know all the questions, like all the answers for the questions, there's no time for you. Okay, so you can't attempt the paper completely within 2 hours, because the duration is 3 hours. You wasted 1 hour, so obviously you're going to lose marks. Okay, so make sure you don't do those kind of mistakes. Once, for example, if the answer, like, you know that answer, but you're not remembering the answer or remembering the point, then what you need to do is just leave the space. How much space is required for the answer? You know it, okay? So just leave that much space exactly, and just go to next answer, okay? At last, like last, in last 10 to 20 minutes, if you're left out with time, happily you can come to this question, and happily you can try to recollect the points, and you can happily write out the answer, okay? Don't waste time for single answer, okay? So now I'm going to tell you how to answer for 2 marks questions, 5 marks questions, 10 marks questions, and 12 marks questions. Different board exam students will be having different types of questions. Few students will have 10 marks, few students will have 7 marks, few students will have 12 marks questions and all. So I'm going to generally tell, okay? So coming to 2 marks question, it's enough if you write 5 to 6 lines of the answer. Okay, first write the definition and write 2 to 3 points explaining the answer. That's it. Okay, for 2 marks, 4 to 5 lines, at max 6 lines is more than enough. Okay, if they ask you to draw something, if they ask to prove some statement, then only just you know, do it, answer it. Otherwise, you need not draw diagrams and all for 2 marks. It's unnecessarily, don't waste your time. Okay, so coming to 5 marks, what you need to do is, first of all, write the definition, explain the points, at least write minimum of 12 lines for 5 marks. to Allah's answer must be there for 5 marks. And if you have any diagram, you have to draw it. If you have any statement, you have to prove it. And coming to 10 marks questions, you have to write the definition, you have to write the explanation points, advantages and disadvantages, and your own points, okay, of 4 to 5 points which you know about the concept, which is very good, okay. And diagrams, tables, flow charts, all whatever is related to the paper, to that concept and answer, you have to provide it, either it is for 10 marks or it is for 12 marks, okay. So few students I saw, as per my knowledge, so the question will be asked for 10 marks or 12 marks. These students will not feel to write. They will just write some 5 to 6 lines and leave it. Though you know answer, if you don't present it on the paper, the examiner will not understand, right? Okay, so and so person is very intelligent, but she or he didn't feel to write in the exam. Let's pass him. Okay, they are not our relatives. So what we need to do is, whatever you have in your brain, that's not enough. You have to present it on your paper, okay? The person who is going to correct your examination paper doesn't know you or me personally, okay? So you have to present it completely on your paper, okay? So these are the 4 or 5 tips. And coming to next thing, few students, instead of understanding the concept, or instead of understanding the answer, they'll start mugging up, okay. So if you're really great at mugging up, or if you're not at all feeling to understand the answer, then it's your personal choice, but I suggest you, instead of mugging up, start learning the answer, okay. Start learning the answer, start understanding the concept, okay. So if you understand the concept, what happens is, though you forgot 1 to 2 points, no problem. So, for example, if I understood a concept, I can write the concept, I can write that answer for 20 lines as well, because I know what is the concept about, I know what are the points of that answer. So, if you mug up, for example, there are 5 lines of the answer, I mugged up, for example, I mugged up all the 5 lines. If I forget second line, that's it, I'll be blocked there, I'll not remember the remaining 3 lines. So that is a great disadvantage of mugging up and great advantage of understanding the concept. So let's see few more points. Okay, so if you find the answer is having so many formulae or so many important points, then what you need to do is, do one thing. Just take a pen and paper, make short notes of all the important points, all the important concepts, as well as all the important formulae, okay. So just before the exam, if you just read out all the points, that's it, you can happily remember easily all these points in your examination. So it's very important, all the toppers also do this, follow all this concepts, they do follow all these concepts and tricks. So you have to maintain a short note and you have to write down all the points and formulae which are very important, or which are which you are forgetting frequently, okay. So just make sure and revise them frequently, okay. If just you write in the book and keep it aside, there's no use. You have to revise it regularly, okay. Even before you go to exam hall, revise and then go to exam hall, okay. So first of all, handwriting, good handwriting is very important. As I said, you good handwriting gives you marks, that's all, okay. So you have to present well, good handwriting, use scale and pencil please, okay. So I have seen many students, they'll draw the diagrams with with rough hands, though you have to draw lines, they'll draw just with hands, you know. So those kinds of things just lose, they'll just take out your marks, okay. They'll just fail you. Make sure you present well, okay. Buy a scale, buy a pencil, buy your stationery. Don't borrow your stationery. Don't waste time in examination hall borrowing your stationery, grasping others and peeping into others' paper. Don't do all those things, okay. So, and next important tip is that, attempt all the questions. For example, They asked you five questions. Out of those, you are asked to present three answers. Okay. Three answers you have presented. Remaining two questions, if you have at least little knowledge about the answer, present them. Okay. So that if out of these three answers, if one of the answer is completely wrong, at least you'll be getting marks from the remaining extra choice answers which you have written. Okay. So, don't leave choice. Manage your time well. That is most important in exams. Manage your time well and, don't leave choice. You have to be very speed at writing with good handwriting. Okay. So manage your time well and write all the answers possible. And next point is take few previous papers, as I said, 4 to 5 years mock, previous papers as well as main papers, take them and try solving them. Okay, keep a stop clock or steep, keep a stopwatch and make down, then you will understand at which question you're wasting time, at which question you're taking more time. Okay, so these kind of things will help you to manage time well in exam, during the exam. Okay, so make sure you even solve those previous papers. Okay, so that even you will understand how good you are at solving the papers. Okay, next, few students will not feel like studying hours and hours continuously. No problem. Study for 1 hour, take break. Study for another hour, take break. At worst case, at least you need to study 4 to 5 hours a day to pass in supplementary exam. There's no substitute for the word called hard work. You have to work hard for success, for passing in the exam. So okay, if you're the student who wants to study at night and who wants to, chill at morning, it's your wish. It's absolutely your personal choice, no problem. But at least study in daytime or during night time. If you're not studying day and night, then nobody can help you. Okay, at least study 4 to 5 hours every day. Okay. And few more important questions, which important tips which I wanted to tell you is, some students will panic so much. They'll be afraid of exams. Exam fever, we'll call it exam fever. Okay, so don't just lose confidence. Be confident. Stay positive. You're going to pass in your exam, and nobody are going to yell at you or beat you. If you fail, it's fine to fail, okay? So it doesn't mean that you will not work hard and you want to pass. It's not like that. You have to work hard. You have to study. You have to follow all the techniques and tips which I told you. Then you're going to pass. And if you are not feeling to study 1 to 1.5 hour, you can just go for a walk. You can watch TV. You can take a short nap and then come back to studying. Okay, at least till the completion of your supplementary exams, concentrate on studies. Study at least 4 to 5 hours. If you have any doubts, then clarify it with your friends or with anybody, with teachers, as soon as possible, because the doubt should not be carried to the next question and the next concept. So few concepts will be related to each other. If you understand this concept only, you're going to understand that concept. So make sure you clarify all your doubts, you present well in your exam, you follow your timetable, and if there's a boring concept which you're not feeling to study, study in small portions. Okay, complete half of the chapter now, complete half of the chapter afternoon, like that. Okay, just divide it into small portions and then start studying instead of just leaving that subject completely. Okay. And first of all, you need to be confident. So that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for more such videos. And like and share this video with all your friends. If you follow these tips, you're going to pass in supplementary exam, and as well as you're going to score very good marks and more marks in betterment exams as well. So all the best for your exams. I'm going to make important questions videos on my channel. So check out those videos and subscribe and share and hit the bell icon. Don't forget to hit the bell icon because whenever I upload a video, you'll be notified whenever I upload a video. So share, like, subscribe and hit the bell icon for more such videos. All the very best for your exams. Thanks for watching.